Welcome back to my channel. My name is Gary Kushtarovich and I am a high performance coach here to help you level up your game. So for today's video, what I wanted to talk about is the use of the slice from an offensive position as well as a defensive position. So primarily the slice is known as a defensive shot, but if used appropriately or in the correct way, you can use it actually as an offensive way to force an error from your opponent and also to change the court position that your opponent is being able to play from. So what I mean by that is when you are stuck in a backhand to backhand rally, when you are rallying cross court, if you are in C, it is a great time to use the standard footwork with your slice to play either deep cross court or deep down the line. You can either play deep cross court to D or deep down the line to A. This will force your opponent to then lift the ball, allowing you to play a bit more aggressively off the next shot. If you are going to actually knife this slice, oftentimes, especially on faster courts, you're gonna get the ball to skid at your opponent and then force them to play the ball up, giving you a slightly higher ball off of which you can step in and be a bit more aggressive. When you are using the slice as a offensive shot, meaning you are forcing the change or you are forcing the error, looking to force the error, a really great way to do so is actually to hold a bit more of a continental slash Eastern grip so that you can actually cut through the ball. So oftentimes we see players coming back into their prep and then slicing down. This forces the ball to actually lift. If we want to cut through the court, we will cut through the ball, through our contact point, more at an angle. This forces the ball to stay a bit lower and also allows us to get a bit more bite on our shot. Now, when we are pushed into more of a defensive position, into D ourselves, a great place to play is obviously deep cross court. But then another fantastic target is to play short to F cross court. This is a highly utilized shot by Roger Federer and Dominic Thiem as they utilize this part of the court to actually force their opponent off the baseline into an uncomfortable position. Now, if you are watching any of the Monte Carlo Rolex Masters, Masters 1000 tournament, you will notice that a lot of players are utilizing both the deep and the short slice to try to create a bit of an error. Yesterday, Dan Evans, playing Novak Djokovic, utilized his slice as well as his one-hander to, as he came over on the ball, to create a bit of variety and create different positions for Novak Djokovic. Djokovic, in his press conference, stated that it was one of the worst matches he played. I think a big part of that goes to show that Dan Evans did a really, really good job of making Novak uncomfortable with the change of spin and change of pace, utilizing the slice a lot. And so something that you guys can use in your game is targeting both deep and short with your slice from different positions. Making sure that you're understanding your court position dictates your shot selection. So if you are in C, yes, you can play to A and to D, as well as slightly shorter to E and F, but for the most part, you're gonna try to keep your opponent deeper in the court. When you are getting pushed into D yourself, getting pulled wide, a really great target to go for is obviously cross court to D, but also utilizing the F target to open up the court, which will give you more time to recover and set up for an even better shot off the next ball. Using these videos, I want you to pay attention to my body position as I'm coming into contact. Notice how I'm staying balanced through both the neutral slice as well as the defensive slice. Understand that a big part of having an effective slice is staying over your feet, making sure that you are balanced as you are executing, making sure that your prep is nice and high so that you can cut through the ball off of a different height ball, not just the low one that maybe forces you to hit a slice on. Make sure you guys are using the slice to set up your regular ground stroke where you can come over the ball, as well as setting yourself up for a potential forehand, which is something that Rublev does a lot. He'll come through his shot and then he'll throw in the chip, which will give him an opportunity to step around the shot and then load up with his forehand. He did this a lot against Robert Bautista Agut in their three-set battle yesterday, and I think it is a really incredible pattern for you guys to implement in your game. I hope you guys got a lot out of today's video, making sure that you're understanding the use of the slice depending on where you are on the court. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel, and make sure you guys tune in next week for another opportunity for you to level up your game.